So good evening to all of you. This is Ranjan from Smart Finance. So I am going to explain you one of the new concept on WD Gann. So many of you will be knowing about the Gann angle method, which I have already explained, Gann price range and time square method, and many methods, mathematical methods I have explained earlier. So this particular method is quite special. It is quite different. And in this particular method, what we are going to identify or predict, we are going to identify the uptrend, downtrend, and the range bound trend. So say Nifty is at plus 10 points. So whether it is in the range bound trend or in the uptrend or downtrend, if it is minus 10 points, if it is whether it is in uptrend, downtrend, or range bound trend. It is a very simple approach, but it is a beautiful approach, very good approach. You can test it, and it is well documented in my book on WD Gann method. So if you can have a copy of my book on Gann method, so here it is well documented how to use the price range methods for your forecast. So this is one of the application, and in the Gann course, the 40 hours video course, you are learning lot of methods to predict the price behavior and time behavior. So here this is a very simple method. So you can just imagine tomorrow if Nifty opens plus 30 point or minus 30 point, or any time during the day if Nifty move by plus 50 point or minus 50 point, how one can identify it is a range bound market, it is a uptrend market, or a downtrend market. So we are going to do it in mathematical way. So see here today, which is when I am recording this video, it is on the 8th December 2022. So here in 8th December, if I can just see here, Nifty has closed at 48.85. So Nifty spot has closed at a positive gain of 48.85. Even though if it is negative, you will be considering only the positive value. If it is minus 48.85 also, we can say it is 48.85 price movement happened. So once I get this 48.85, so what I have to do here, 48.85 price point positive gain, instead of in case of negative gain also, I will be considering only the positive value, because I am going to forecast a price point or the range in which the price will be range bound, price will be trend negative, price will be trend positive. So here, after getting these things, I am just hooking to one of the concept of WD Gann, which says that Gann cycle. So many of you, those who are the follower of the Gann, they will be knowing about the Gann cycle. And many of you, those who are following the square of 9 table also, you will be knowing about the Gann cycle. That means a 360 degree rotation of the price or time is known as a Gann cycle. 360 degree rotation. So every 360 degree rotation, one new spiral generates in the square of 9. Every 360 degree rotation, one spiral generate in the square of 12. So similar way, so 360 degree is one cycle. So I am going to find out the cycle price point from the price range. So what I did, I took the square root of 48.85. So 48.85. So here I am just taking the square root of 48.85. So 48.85, so 48.85, and I am taking a square root, it is giving me 6.9892, and I am adding the degree factor of 360 degree, which is 2. So on degree factor, you will be getting lot of literatures in my book as well as in our YouTube videos. So it is coming to 8.9892. So this 8.9892 9892. I'll be taking a double multiple or a square. So this I am taking as a square. So I'm getting 80.80. So 80.80 is my price. So I got a 80.80. So this is the cycle price point. Tomorrow, if the Nifty move plus or minus 81 point, I am just rounding it to 80.80 to 81 point, then I can say the Nifty has completed one cycle of price movement. So how to utilize it? Now we have to move to the next level, wherein we have to find out cycle price point. We have found out, now we have to find out in this cycle price point of 360 degree rotation, every 15 degree consider as a cycle turning point. Means you'll be meeting with one resistance, you'll be meeting with one support at every 15 degree multiple. And this is again a powerful concept which is present in the Gann line, or you can say Gann line, 11 trend lines, based on that we are doing certain trades. So this is a concept present there. So there I am just grouping these angles, those who are the multiple of 15 and multiple of 45, into two groups. One is 15 to 90, this is known as a minor cycle as per the Gann. So those who are little well versed with the Gann's concept, they will be knowing that in numbers or the degrees from 0 to 90 are minor cycle. So once we move above 90, so we are going to a gray zone till 135 degrees, and post 135 degree to 360 degree we enter to a major trend cycle. So I'm just grouping this thing here. So grouping this thing here, and I'll be just 15 to 45, 15, 45, 75, 90, and 135 to 360. So this is the place, or this is the groupings of the angles we have done based on their minor cycle and the major cycle. So in this, I'm just multiplying my 81 price point. So here I got 80.80, my calculations. So this 80.80 calculations I did here, same way here, 80.80. So this I am multiplying with all angle factors. Here 180 degree is a factor 1. So 15 degree will be nothing but 15 divided by 180. 90 degree will nothing but 90 divided by 180. 360 degree factor will be nothing but 360 divided by 180. So by based on that, I'm just multiplying the cycle price range. What I have derived here, the cycle price point or the cycle price range with the angle factors, and I'm getting different price range. So this different price range I am going to use for my trend identification. Means I am going to identify how many price points the Nifty should move so that I can say it is in a uptrend. How many price points it should fall so that I can say it is in a downtrend price. So how to read this table? So I am going for 45 degree. So here it says any price point. Suppose these calculations I have done on the 8th of December post market hour, on 9th of December, if Nifty opens or any point of time moves plus or minus 20 points, so this 20 is nothing but the 45 degree price points, then I will say it is in the range bound trend. If it is moving in that range of plus 20 to minus 20 points, the moment it moves above 90 degree price cycle points, which is plus 40, I will say that the range is broken now. Range is broken now, either plus 40 or minus 40. So I will say that the range is broken now. The minor trend range is broken now, and we are in a clear up move or down move. So if it is plus 40 points, I can say that it is clearly entered to a uptrend now. So if it is minus 40 point, I will say that it is clearly entered to a downtrend. So once this movement happens 40 above, so I can say next levels it should go 60, 80, 101, 141 and 161 points. So these are the price moves the Nifty can show in the shortest possible time or the available time in that particular day. So this is a beautiful concept, and this is a great concept in the WD Gann to know a range bound price action, a uptrend price action, a downtrend price action. So these price actions you can easily identify based on the previous day's close, previous day's price range it has offered. Say one particular day, so here we are seeing that on 8th of December it is 48.85. So I have taken as it is. Say 9th of December it is closing at 165 points. So if I take this 165 points and if I can find out the cycle price points, then it will be a very big number. So 165 square root I will take, again I have to add the 2 and multiply or take the double multiple, it will go to 220 points. Then 15 degree, 45 degree, 70 and 90 also will give you a bigger numbers. So there the confusion comes. If at any point of time the Nifty closes above 80 points, then our calculation will always point to a range bound trend. So it is not true. So how to come with that? So how to counter that? How to come out of that particular moves? So here to counter that, you need to do a very small tweaking in this method. So as long as it is in the minor trend cycle, it is not an issue. Once it goes to the major trend cycle, so 60 above, if it goes to 60, 80, 101, 141 or 161, any price range if it is closing, so what you have to do now, you need to consider 48.85 as your base and do the calculations only from the 48.85 if the price is closing above 80.80. above 80.80. So if it is closing in a range below 80.80, nothing to worry. So you can say it is closing at 60, you take 60, calculate the price cycle points and do all this. However, if it is closing above 80.8, which is your 180 degree above, then you should not consider the 161, rather you still consider the 48.85. The reason is we have to concentrate in the inner cycle. So in a square of 9 wheel. So if it is a huge price range, what we have to do? We need to concentrate on the inner cycle. So this is only one rule or one extra mathematical calculation you need to obey. Other than that, nothing else you need to obey in this, and you can utilize this method. So today 8th December we are recording this event. So tomorrow you can watch out. If the Nifty gives a plus 40 point or minus 40 point, then the trend is going to change and trend is going to give you a proper uptrend or back or a downtrend movement. As long as it's consolidated with a plus or minus 40 points, then you can say you are in a range bound trend and the range bound trend will continue. So keep utilizing this method. It's a very simple calculations. Just take the price range, add the 360 degree factor, take the double multiple and use the angle factors, multiples with the price range, and watch out for those levels. So if tomorrow I am saying that if Nifty is at a plus 40 point, I'll be confident that yes, it will be the uptrend and it will give me or reward me another 20 more points. And once it crosses 60 points, I can further expect that I can get to 20 more points more. So if it is not moving in that range, then I can say it is in a range bound trend and it is better to stay away from the market. So this is a very beautiful and well crafted concept by WD Gann, and more on such kind of concepts, more on the Gann's literatures you can find out in this 40 hours of course, which explains many complex mathematical calculations in a simple way. Thank you very much. Thank you for your time.